Caitlin, Deniz, thanks for your time today. Congratulations on tomorrow when the world began. You must be very pleased with the way it's turned out. Now, obviously having been stars on the smaller screen, what was it like when you go to the premiere and see your head in, you know, 20 feet tall on the screen? What was that like as a first experience?
Weird.
Yeah.
Because when we were filming, we couldn't have possibly imagined the fan base. You know about it and you hear about it, but you can't comprehend it until you're actually exposed to it. And just what this film means to, what we hope it means to the Australian film industry.
Walking out of that car for the first time on those premieres was even just a bit of a squeal in the headlights.
Yeah.
Jesus, what's going on? So, I don't know, it's all a bit, you know, insane at this moment, but we'll see.
Now, this is a very Australian film, obviously. It was written about Australian teenagers and the flag we see fluttering on four or five occasions, I counted. Do you think there's possibilities of sequels for this?
We would love to be a part of that. Of course, we'd love to make sequels, but it comes down to the fans and if they want us to. I mean, if they want us to, then they've got to go and see the film, and they've got to pay to see it, and they've got to take their friends, and they've got to tell people. It's just about their dedication.
If people love it as much as we love making it, then we're, you know, more than keen for a second and third. Just because we've got so much more to do. I mean, we're just in the thick of the war now, so.
Well, as I say, it was clearly the way it finishes, the opportunity for a sequel is left there. We'll see. Kevin has to be retrieved from the hospital and all that kind of stuff.
Well, he stepped up in the end. Kevin made amends and redeemed himself in a sense. But, there's, you know, we've got to fight back. We've got to get our town back.
And the Australian nature of the film, do you think that, is that going to be an impediment for it playing in overseas audiences?
I think what's great about this film is that it is a specifically Australian story, but it's also very commercial. Whereas with a lot of our films, I think they don't translate universally because they probably are too specific. And not to say that our film is Americanized in any way, but it's universal. There isn't the use of many colloquialisms, which, you know, we wanted, but it doesn't always work. We're patriotic in every sense of the word with this film, but it's just, we weren't too specific. And I think that will help it. And people like seeing films where they don't know anybody, and they like seeing films with different, you know, it's like District 9. People like seeing, you know, funny accents.
Yeah.
So,
and the accents and the backdrop as well. I mean, it's the country, the Australian countryside is almost another character in the film. It's so beautiful, so I think that would draw people as well, because they've seen it every now and then, but not in this sense, not in an action film, yeah, like since Mad Max, so hopefully everyone else will enjoy it as much as Australians will.
Certainly that scenery from Hell was very, very attractive.
Yeah.
Well, that was only about 5 minutes from, well, literally, there was all these houses around, and you take this little walk down some steps, and you're out of suburbia and into the wilderness.
Yeah, it's about 5 minutes from Residential Street.
It's in Woolloomooloo. It's in, I forget it. Warrawood.
Now, for each of you, this film, is it kind of a calling card for the next thing in terms of being able to show this sort of production, given it might be relatively Australian-centric at the end of the day? Or is this a crowd, or is this about showing that you can pull a crowd and therefore being able to launch it through that sort of attraction to Hollywood?
I think this film, I hope it's the beginnings of a resurgence in the Australian film industry, so that people make bigger films here, and then therefore are allowed to make their smaller films more frequently.
So more people take risks into invest into Australian films. I mean, you know, ours.
And we get Australian audiences back into Australian films because they're not interested at the moment.
Yeah,
and anyone I speak to is like, I wasn't going to see it because it's Australian, but it looks cool. You know, which is disappointing, but that's just how it is.
Because it's a great Australian stories to tell, and if no one takes a risk to go out there and try to tell them, it'd just be a real shame.
Yeah.
But for your own personal careers, what does, you know, being in this tomorrow film mean for you when you try and push your reputations and aspirations, say, in a Hollywood setting?
I mean, it depends if it gets released overseas. We don't know what it means for us personally, because you can never anticipate what people are going to think about us.
Yeah.
When you're, you know, the leads in a film, generally it means people are interested in seeing you, but if there's nothing happening, there's nothing to see us for.
Right now, it's just me playing out a childhood fantasy.
So, yeah, right now it's just about this film. That's all we really could focus our efforts on.
Now, both of you have potentials of other careers. Caitlin, in your case, you've been done singing and theatre. Where do things sit with those possibilities? Or is this now it?
No, I would love to do theatre again. I'd never sing again because singing isn't where my heart lies. And I don't know it. I'm not trained really in the theory of music well enough to consider myself a musician by any means. I love music, but it's not my thing. And I love theatre. Deniz Deniz and I both share a love of theatre, and your experience is probably more extensive than mine, but we trained at the same places.
Yeah.
And I think every actor should do theatre at least once, because you have to demand an immediate response from your audience. But I'd do anything. You know, not anything, obviously. There's some really great television that gets made, but then you get locked in for 7 years, and then once it gets to the third year, it kind of levels out, becomes a bit generic. So I film and theatre, small projects that you can dedicate a set amount of time to and then move on.
Yes, you also have not only theatre but jiu-jitsu to fall back on. You're a Victorian state champion, I think.
Yeah.
Where does jiu-jitsu now sit in this? Or just simply a way of handling fans?
Well, it's all a bit of both. I was 16, 17 when I was competing, and I still train. I mean, I love it. It's a weird thing to love, but once you try it, you'll understand. And I don't think that's more of a pastime. It's more of a way for me to clear my mind in a weird sense. It's just, it's very freeing, just like acting. So I'll keep training until I croak. But it's never I couldn't go up there in a cage and fight for a career. I don't think I have it in me. But, yeah.
Caitlin, Deniz, many thanks, and I hope the film does well on its release.
Thank you very much.